thanks, son.
Yeah.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Hey, we're excited
that you all are here with us today to worship our true Lord and Savior in truth and spirit. That's what we're here for, right?
Amen.
So, let's start off, if everybody's again, with stand. And page 133 of Come On Faithful. We're going to fellowship on this song. Again, tonight we welcome everybody here. And just say we're glad to be here today.
Thank you. pulpit.
So we want to welcome you this morning. It looks good to look out and see the views. So cool. So next Sunday, we're going to have service again at 11 o'clock. Choir is not going to be singing this year, but you can come right back out again next Sunday at 11 o'clock, okay? So we'll be glad to have you. But now, we want to thank each and every one of you that came out this morning to be with us. We want to pray that God watch over you and bless you, that He fill you up this morning. You know, it's a special season that we have, that we're up on right now. This is the season that we celebrate our Savior, His birth, what He done while He was here on this earth. This is the reason for this season. It's not all the other stuff that we celebrate sometimes. This is the true reason. Jesus is the reason that we celebrate this morning. So I'm glad that you came with us. Now, we like to always just open up any service. We want to open it up just the way we always do it. We want to ask anybody this morning if they have an unspoken prayer by raising up your hand this morning. Hands up throughout the house. Praise God. So anybody have a spoken prayer request upon your heart this morning? Don't be shy. It's okay.
For everyone in the world to see the true reason of Christmas.
Amen. Didn't say it better. That's exactly right. Anybody else have a spoken prayer request from your heart this morning?
I want to remember my son, Curtis Murphy, in prayer.
Amen. Just remember that this morning. Someone else?
Remember the family with Ann Mullen? She was 7 years older than me. She was already possible.
Absolutely. Remember all the families where dads has come. Definitely need your prayers. It's the time of season. It's very hard at this time of year. It's hard to lose family any time of year, but especially this time of year. So please remember families where dads has come, where sickness is. Let's remember the loss this morning when we pray. You know, what we sometimes neglect that, sometimes forget, but that is what Jesus was all about, the loss. The sick needs a physician, not the healthy. So that's the reason why Jesus came. That's the reason why he done what he done. So let's remember the loss this morning. Someone else this morning? Well, we can always remember me and my family. We don't have anything else to pray about. Always remember us. Pray that we be found in what God would have us to do. Pray for our church here beside the road. Pray for all of the churches throughout the land that preach God's word, wherever they are. I'm not hung up so much over what's right above the door. It's the door that I'm hung up on. That door named Jesus Christ. So that's the one I'm hung up on this morning. So please be much in prayer for the other churches also. Anyone else this morning before we go to the Lord's word of prayer? Now, I like to always offer. If you want to, please feel free to come to these altars and pray. The altars was for the Christians. So if you want to come to the altars and pray, please do so this morning. I'll just open that up to you right now. But if not, you can pray from where you're at. That's fine also. But I would like to go to the altar.
God, we thank you, Lord, most of all, Lord, for your son, Jesus, Lord, that died on that cross on Calvary for us. God, we thank you, Lord, for the opportunity, Lord, to become a child of yours. God, we thank you for the opportunity, Lord, to be saved, to be able to start over, Lord, as a newborn baby, God. God, I pray, Lord, this morning, yes, God, that you'd speak to every heart that you'd fill them, God, from the bottom of their feet, Lord, to the top of their head. I pray, God, that you just put your message of love within them, God. That they know, Lord, that they've been to church this morning, God. That they know that the reason why we came this morning, Lord, was to uplift your name, Lord, and to give you praise. God, I pray, Lord, that you help each and every one, Lord, to know the real reason for Christmas, Lord. God, I pray, Lord, that you just bless, Lord, in this service. Lord, bless in all the services throughout the land, Lord. Any service, Lord, that preach your word, God, I pray, Lord, that you bless. That if there be one lost in here, Lord, or one lost in any other church service this morning, God, I pray, Lord, that you call out to their heart, that you let them know, God, that they need you more than they need anything else. God, I ask you, Lord, that you remember the prayer request, whether he spoke or not spoke. And I pray, Lord, that you move in every circumstance. God, I pray, Lord, that you remember the home, Lord, where dad is, Lord, where sickness is. I pray, God, that you bless us this day, God. God, we ask you, Lord, that you bless, Lord, as our singers prepare to sing for you, Lord. God, I pray, Lord, that you bless them, God. That you fill them, Lord, with your spirit today. Let each and every one of them, Lord, sing like we stand before you, God. God, I pray, Lord, that you please fill this service, Lord, with your spirit. That you come down of all comments today, Lord. God, I pray, Lord, that you give me the words, Lord, that you have me to say, Lord, this morning. And God, I pray, Lord, that you remember our comfort. That you bless, Lord, that you help us, Lord, to put you back in all the things, Lord, we cut you out of. God, I pray, Lord, that you remember our leaders, God, that you give them wisdom, Lord. And God, that you just please help them, Lord. To let them know, Lord, that you lead this country, Lord. God, we love you. We praise you. We thank you this morning, Lord. We ask you, Lord, that you bless your son Jesus' precious name this morning. Amen. Amen.
We'd like to welcome everybody here again, and on behalf of the choir and Sister Jackie, we welcome you, and we welcome the visitors, the people that normally attend here. We especially welcome you, and we especially welcome all of the visitors. You know, we're on this journey with the Lord in this world, in this life, and that journey takes us different places. And today, that journey brought each and every one of you all here today. This time, for some reason. So, we're here, and our cantata, Sing Gloria, talks about God's love for each and every one of us. It emphasizes the hope we can all have in Him, in our Lord and Savior. And it talks about His holy presence, Emmanuel, God with us. Wow. Can you imagine our Creator, our Savior, our soon coming King right here with us today? We're excited, and we hope you're excited too. We're going to sing from our heart, for Christ is the reason we sing. The first song is a carol medley. You will know the words of the song. You'll recognize the songs. So we're inviting you to join in with us and sing that first song. It'll help you praise the Lord, and it'll help you get in the Christmas spirit. We thank you so much for being here today, and Merry Christmas, and may God bless each and every one of you.
It's Christmas. Ring the bells, sound the trumpets, proclaim the glory of Christ who has come to dwell among his people. This is the season to rejoice, and what better way to celebrate than to sing?
Sing, 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 this is the time for rejoicing. Come, lift your voices and sing. salvation. The writings of the prophets will foreshadow their events to come as the world longs for a Redeemer. Centuries of hope and wonder will pass as they waited for God to fulfill His covenant in Israel.
Thank you. that are craving her newborn in her arms. But the same department may be more different on nearby hillside for some shepherds who'd watch over their sheep. An angel of the Lord appeared in the heavens with the announcement of ages that Christ the Lord was born in the city of David. As amazing as that moment must have seemed for the nervous shepherds, they had no way of knowing church was just getting started. Suddenly, the angel was joined by a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men."
For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace there shall be no end.
Thank you. trying to base the entire story of Christmas down to one word, it would have to be love. For nothing short of love, we can tell a father to give his only begotten son, so that whoever believed in him can live forever. Only love would permit a king to come as a pauper, to exchange the glory of heaven for the agony of the cross. Only love would look beyond who we have been and what we have done and see something worth redeeming. Yes, love truly is the story of Christmas.
Thank you. As I listened to this morning, and I thought about this season that we're in, it means something special to me. Now, if you're in here and you're lost this morning, it may not mean that much to you. It may not have that special meaning to you this morning. But if you're saved in here, this season means everything. This season means it all. What we're celebrating this season is the birth of our Christ, the one who provided the salvation for each and every one of us that's here this morning. The one that came from the splendors of heaven into a stall in Bethlehem. Humble. He would take a king, the Lord of Lords and the King of Kings would come to a golden laid table, to a golden laid bed, to the fanciest of fancy hospitals nowadays. But he came to a manger. And he lay in the straw, wrapped in swaddling clothes. And just like now, the world had no room for him then. They said there was no room for him in the end. So that's the reason why he was born in the stable. This world still has no room for Jesus Christ. But those of us who know him as Lord and Savior, praise God. There's something special about knowing him as Lord and Savior this morning. You may have more money than me. You may be better looking than me this morning. You may, praise God, have a nicer family than I do. You may drive a nicer car. And you may live in a nicer home. But if you don't know Jesus Christ as your Savior this morning, praise God, you're missing out on the glory of heaven this morning. You're missing out on the glories that comes by knowing him as your Lord and Savior. There's a song that I like. I listen to it over and over and over. It says, praise God, that I may be poor on this earth, but I'm rich in glory. I'm rich in heaven this morning. It's because of this man, Jesus Christ. It's because of this time that we're celebrating right now is the reason why I have my salvation. And if you're here and you're saved, it's the reason why you have your salvation. There's not a one of us sitting here this morning that's worthy of salvation. No, not one. There's none of us that can live well enough to pay for our own salvation. No, not any of us. And God looked down and he realized this. And he said, I'll send my son. Now I have two boys this morning, and I can tell you right now, he loved this world an awful lot. He loved you an awful lot because I couldn't get my children to go die on a cross. He loved you a lot this morning when he said in this program that it's about love. It is about love this morning. Don't let anyone tell you any different. It's not about the packages you have under your tree this morning. It's not about how many presents you can buy your babies or your loved ones. It's not about how pretty your tree or your home's decorated. It's not about, praise God, having the nicest house on the block. It's about Jesus Christ this morning. It's about what he is and what he means to you this morning.
Amen.
He either is your Savior this morning or you don't know him this morning. There's only two ways. You say, well, I've been raised in church all of my life. I know Jesus Christ. I was raised in church all of my life too, and I knew of Jesus Christ. I didn't know Jesus Christ until the day that he came into my life and he saved me. And since then, praise God, I've never been the same. I'm not the same as I was before I met him. I'll never be the same again, praise be to God, because of this baby and because of what he done with his life and how he laid his life down for me. I'll never be the same again. That's why we celebrate Christmas. It doesn't have anything to do with the beautiful gifts and how much you can spend on one another. And we get me and you don't even understand. He loved you so much while you was yet in your sins, Bible said. He didn't send his son to die for the saved. He sent his son to die for the lost.
Amen.
The drug addicts, praise be to God, with the needles in their arms. Praise God, the prostitutes this morning. The people, praise God, that we see their nose up and walk away from. That's the ones that he sent his son to die for this morning.
Amen.
For me and you this morning.
Amen.
We like to paint our sins sometimes. We like to paint our sins as white than the next person down the road's sin.
Amen.
I got this for you, sin's black. I don't care how little it is. I don't care how big it is. I don't care whether you justify it or whether you don't. Sin is sin. And the Bible says where he is, that sin can't enter in. I want you to know something this morning. If not for this baby that we're celebrating today, if not for this birth, praise be to God, me and you would be lost forevermore. But driven by what Jesus Christ does, our Lord and King, our soon coming Savior, by through about what he done this morning, me and you have an opportunity to go to heaven. Say, that's fables, preacher. That's stories. I'd like to open my chest and show you my heart. I don't look any different than anyone else on the outside. I may be a little uglier. No. I don't look any different on the outside. I'd like to show you the inside. Whoa, my God. There's a Lord that lives inside of me. A King of Kings and the glory. Praise be to God. There's a difference in the inside of me. It's not a fable this morning. It's as true this morning, praise God, as it is that I'm standing here talking to you this morning. It's real this morning. And if you don't think it is, please, please, please wake up this morning. It's true. It's true this morning. He is the Lord of lords and the King of kings this morning. He came and he died on Calvary for me and you. And he paid a price that we couldn't pay. And he paid for each and every one that sits in here and hears me this morning. Everyone that may be watching. He paid a price for you. Your sins held him to that cross. He climbed up there and he got on that cross. It wasn't the nails that held him there. It was love for me and you that held him there this morning. And he paid a price this morning that we couldn't pay. We like extravagant things sometimes. And boy, extravagant things cost a lot of money. We drive cars sometimes nowadays that cost more than homes used to cost 10 years ago. Is that not true? We like things that's nice. This salvation is free. It don't cost you a penny this morning. It's totally free. But I want you to know something. It wasn't free for him. It wasn't free for heaven. It wasn't free for my Lord and Savior. Every drop of precious blood he had, he shed on the cross for me and you. Every drop. I ain't worthy this morning. I'm not worthy. But he loved me so much. And he said he'd save me. Christmas is not about paper, bows, gifts. It's about the precious gift that was given on that night in a stable. Wrapped in swaddling clothes, the whole of the world, think about it, was laying in stable. Precious baby. Swaddling clothes. And he's your hope and he's my hope this morning. The Bible says, in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 19, it says, if in this life only we have hope in Christ, we are of all men most miserable. If all you have hope in this life, is Christ in this life, you're involved in the most miserable. My hope doesn't die with me when this body dies. My hope goes on because my Lord and Savior lives, praise be to God. This morning, he lives and he's alive and well. And my hope's in Jesus Christ. It's not in Brother Ted or Brother Joe or anybody else that goes to this church. It's not in the pastor that was preaching the morning I got saved. My hope don't lie in nothing. Oh, this morning, my hope lies in Jesus Christ. Praise be to God. He's alive and hope this morning. I deserve it. It'll be because my hope lies in Him.
Yeah. Amen.
Amen, brother.
That precious blood that He gave was for people like me and you. People that didn't deserve it, as much as we might think we did. People that didn't deserve it, He gave it free. Free. Freely. He laid down His life to give you life. Think about that. Very seldom is that ever done, right? Very seldom is that ever done. Not only did He lay it down, but what makes it different is that He picked it back up again. And He's alive and well. And His mother's ahead. This morning, let me ask you a question. Do you know Jesus is your Savior? Do you know why we celebrate this season? Truly, in your heart, do you know why we celebrate this season? I hope you do, because I just spent 10 minutes telling you why. I hope you do. But if you don't, I hope it gets on your heart so heavily that you can't stand it. I hope it gets in your mind so heavily that you can't get it out. That Jesus Christ is the reason for this season. Don't tell me happy holidays, praise God. It's Merry Christmas, praise God. My Lord and Savior is the reason for this Christmas. He's the reason for this season. I love seeing those signs. You see them in yards sometimes. And sometimes, occasionally, you'll see it in a storefront window. That's amazing nowadays. Jesus is the reason for the season. He is the reason for this season. Don't let nobody fool you. He is the reason why I live and breathe, and why you live and breathe this morning. He is my all in all this morning. I love my wife and I love my children, but my Jesus is my all in all this morning. Without Him, I have nothing, I am nothing, and I will never become anything. But through and by Him and what He done on Calvary and His blood that He shed, and He gave a remission of sin, praise God. Through His remission of sin, through what He done for me, praise God, I got a promise one day to live in glory forever. To walk on a street of gold, to live in a mansion, praise be to God, to worship Him forever. That's the reason for this season. I can't make it any clearer than that. If you don't know Jesus Christ as your Savior this morning, you're missing out. You're missing out here. But I promise you, you're missing out on something even better. There'll come a day, the Bible says that every knee of bow, every tongue will confess. We will answer to Jesus Christ. You will stand before Him, either a saved child of His, and He will be your Redeemer. You will stand before Him and you will be your judge. What do you want this Christmas season? There's a lot of things I want under my tree. There's a lot of things I'd like to have. And blah, blah, blah. But the one thing I need is salvation. The one thing you need this morning is salvation. They sang every song was about this man named Jesus. Everything about this season is about Him. Don't let nobody else fool you to think it's not. I don't worship a tree. I don't worship any presence that's under a tree, nor do I worship the decoration that's hanging on a tree. I worship Jesus Christ. He is my Lord of Lords, my King of Kings this morning. I love Him this morning. Where do you stand with Him this morning? Find us the song. Yes.
Thank you.
these seats today with me. There's miracles sitting right here. It's because of Jesus Christ. Nothing else. I work around doctors every day. I love them. I respect them. But I'll be honest with you. Jesus makes the problem. Whether you live or die, that's easy. It's not much. As we can. Now, as you listen to them singing a song, I want you to think. Some of you may already be ready for Christmas. You may have every package under the tree. And we're not fortunate enough to be that way. We never are. We'll be wrapping an hour before we open. That's just the way it is in my house. But the present that I have, I got 15 years ago. And it's the present. You're talking about a present that gives and gives and gives and gives. That's the present that just keeps on giving. His name is Jesus Christ. Do you know him for him? I'm going to be ready. Lord, that's 275. Do you know him this morning as your Savior? Forget about all this. Forget about packages and all that. Forget about all that. Do you know him as your Savior? You're either saved by him or you're not. I put everything in good terms. I've always said this to the church. It's like me and the regular in here. You either have to touch or you don't. You got Jesus or you don't. That's just the way it is. Don't make you a bad person. This is a fact. You're either saved or you're not this morning. You know him as your Savior or you're lost this morning. I'm not being mean. I'm not trying to put you out of the city. Well, this world is uncertain. We don't know when we'll close our eyes for the last time. You say, well, I'm done, preacher. I've told the story many times about all the sins. I've told that in my heart because it's the last breath of age. Age don't have anything to do with it. It's not a thing. When your time is up, it's up. No doctor can lengthen that. No medicine can cure it. When your time is up, it's up. And you will stand before this man, and I told you about his name, Jesus. Why would you want to stand in this morning? And let him be your judge. You need to stand and let him be your Savior. You're an angel. I'll take him. I'll take the Savior. I'll take him. I don't have anything to do with him. He's a good God this morning.